bridges of sin. Bound, oppressed, tormented, sick of it. For the power of the Lord is still the same. Yes, I won't go back as I can in Jesus' name. Libera sinner, I won't go back as I can in Jesus' name. Bound, oppressed, tormented, sick of it. Listen, you won't go back as you came in Jesus' name. Even though you are bound, oppressed, and tormented, sing a day. And for the power of the Lord is still the same. In Jesus' name, you better say, I won't go back as I can in Jesus' name. Bound, oppressed, tormented, sick of it. For the power of the Lord is still the same.
Celebration of Power Assembly. The key word for today is the password. Who knows the password? You know, if you can, another version of it. It says, just apply the password. And the password is what? Thank you. And that's what we're doing today. And so it's not out of place when you dance, even out of place. David did. And who are you?
I hear you.
Amen? Who are you? And I saw somebody looking at somebody else the way they're dancing. The person is dancing to the throne. You are looking. You won't be an onlooker in Jesus' name. Let me welcome Daddy and Pastor Mrs. Bazuno. Uncle Tony, it's good to see you. I'm so excited to see you again. Tony Bazuno, thank you for bringing him. Hey. I want to also recognize Pastor Evans Akendra. I came with his wife. Mama Malawi is in the house. Evangelist Makero. Where is Danny? No, we have to see him again.
Okay, yes,
before you go to Malawi, yeah?
Hallelujah.
Wonderful things in Malawi. I mean, I see the poster every day and I'm excited. The way I knew Malawi to be, and now what the ministry is doing in that particular zone of the country.
Hallelujah.
Very soon, those people will take over the country, because I know that. Every day your eyes are opening, they are beginning to see the benefits of knowing Jesus Christ. Deacon and Mommy Ogundipe from Tampa, he met the director of this ministry. Mommy, stand up, stand up. She is surprised because I call her Mommy. Mommy, because you are now the Mommy, you are now, Daddy is gone now, so you are Mommy. You are now the Mommy. I'm talking about your father. I just want to thank God for the life of your father who passed in the last week. The Lord will keep all the families together even after his death. Deaconess and Mrs. Adefala from CAC. If I don't recognize you, I know that the Lord God recognized you. I want to also, there is no way I will not come back home. Very important. Then first of all, let me get our pastors. Pastor Harris. Pastor Harris, I need to recognize you. We also have Pastor Sheun Oladipupo. Daddy, where's that? The wives are here and I recognize them as well. We have some guests. Okay, let me start from the guests. Artists. Do I call them artists or musicians? I don't even know what to call them now. It's been awesome. I told Brother Chris 2 years ago, that he needs to relocate to Orlando.
Yeah.
He's still working on it. What about when we have yesterday I wrote out a mail saying High Prince. Today is Higher Prince. So what about when we come to terms and when we have to have a good High Prince in Orlando?
Yeah.
If you say amen, then we know it's true.
Yeah.
So get ready. Get ready. We ask the Lord, may the Lord continue to be with you in Jesus' name. It was an awesome time in the presence of the Lord. He came all the way from New York. Thank you, Brother Chris. Everybody, maybe I should call him an evangelist, because I always know that people who sing to bring people to the kingdom of the Lord are also called evangelists. Literally, or psalmist, you say psalmist, the psalmist, for psalmist, for evangelist, everything. But I want to recognize one young lady who had been, I've not met her before, but I call her a golden voice. Golden voice. Sister, let me borrow the frame, evangelist. Idowu Eyin from Uganda. Stand up for recognition. I don't know whether she's going to have opportunity today, but you know, if you are here in the last 2 days, you probably want to see her again. Love best to sit down. And let me come back home. Our dear lady. sing some stress or whatever they call it. We need to recognize you. I put evangelist, you are not evangelist. I don't know, you are not ordained that yet. But evangelist, blessing, she goes a bit further. Yesterday was awesome. The two of them blasted this whole place. And I didn't know what was coming. It's going to get bigger, better, stronger, sweeter, in the mighty name of Jesus. Now to our guests. Let me recognize the son of the house. He's been here many, many years. He's been coming here since the inception of this ministry. I think the first guest minister we had in Power Assembly at McLeod was this man that I was going to introduce, Pastor Femi Junai from South Africa. He is the senior pastor, Glory Christian Center in Pretoria. So greet all the Glory Land people for me. They were so nice when I was there. I really enjoyed the service. So, Pastor Junai, you are the son of the house. We know you very well. So then, but he performed a prophetic. Meaning that he did a prophetic thing on Thursday.
Yes.
And that's where I was coming. That after that, breaking of the covenant to see the glory.
Yes. because your ministry is glory land. After that, he's not getting better and better. And I need a prophecy. Even the prophetic job, I was going to call you a prophet. The world of the Lord, you see, it's a mystery. The Lord will give it to some people. And when he gives it to some people, you begin to see, I've read that before many times. I've understood this very time. How many times have I seen coconut? Coconut is sweet, but I never knew that when I break it. We all know in the book of Daniel, I'm not supposed to preach here. But until when they broke the pot, yes, the glory of the Lord, the light shine. Yes,
that's it.
So I believe so, that he had made the utterance. That that's the end of toiling in our life. I want to greet you so much. I want you to take the message back to the Glory Land people. We love them for leaving you after a 20th anniversary. I know what it takes, and I know the number of children you have over there. For leave them the second day and come over here tomorrow. The Lord will honor you in Jesus' name. And our mommy. He taught me also the word. Because we look at the word, let the glory fall. We are looking at the glory, but we are not looking at the let. It taught us the fact that the glory is there. It's yours. But are you letting the glory fall?
Permit it.
Permit. And there are many words that she used. Thank you. Permit. Allow. Mommy Favor, the Lord bless you. Pastor Mrs. Favor, Junai. They call her Mama of the Church. Mama of the Church. South Africa. She's an anointed praise worshiper. Yes. We didn't give her opportunity to, but she, the little one we saw was fine. She's an anointed praise worshiper. The Lord bless you. The Lord bless you and your children in Jesus' name. Amen. And so let me come back to introduce the GO, General Overseer of our ministry, Pastor Dr. Chris Bakare. Please have a shout out for the there is still more time to pray. It's a Thanksgiving service, so I'm going to make this very brief. And every one of us, as if you are worshiping with us for the very first time, please let me recognize you. Brother Balogun, you're welcome. I see you. Almost a year. Maybe I should take these glasses off. And I recognize everybody. Mommy Abioye, you're welcome. I want to recognize you too. Praise the Lord. At the back of the bulletin, we all have it. I just want to refer one or two things on there. I don't want to read through it, but particularly every Wednesday in the morning between the hours of 9 and 12, we have prayer going on. It's called intercessory prayers, and we pray for the city, the church, individuals, even the nation. And so if you have any opportunity within the 3 hours, please come around here and join the intercessory prayer session between the hours of 9 and 12. And in the evening of that day is our Bible study. It starts at 7 p.m. and ends at 8 p.m. So we'll be expecting to see you. Please bring somebody along when you come. We have a prayer teleconference in this ministry Monday through Saturday from 10 p.m. to 10:30. 30 minutes. At the back of the bulletin is the conference. And you can join. You don't have to be a member of Power Assembly to be in prayer. I want to also announce that November 2nd, please take note in your calendar, November 2nd, our sister, Blessing Chigozie, will be having a concert with some other anointed ministers on the 2nd of November. If you want to know more, I think there's a flyer going on, so if you don't have one, please ask her at the end of the service. Please let's go out all and support this ministry. I mean, if you support this ministry, you're supporting the Lord. Spread of the gospel, amen. Lord bless you. But Doctor, I still see you. You don't look away. Dr. Show, please, you're welcome. Thank you. Please stand up for recognition. Thank you so much. Thank you for coming. And if there's going to be any, there's not many other announcements, but please bear with us as we come up here. There's going to be a lot of other recognitions too. As we get into it, please, we appreciate your patience. But let's do something. Let's bring the hand of the Lord down. I have studied in the Bible that for every blessing there's always a command. There's always something. There's always one word. Prayer. And so some of us are using this offering time like a seed time. You know, some of us are even using the offering as thanks. It could be anything for you, but I know that the Lord God, it doesn't matter whether we are billions, He's the one who created you and He hears all voices in any languages, in any way you say it, He answers prayers. So by the virtue of that reasoning, I want us to get your envelope ready. Offering time. Offering time. Offering time. This is the part that I love most. The reason is because I have heard that the blessing is already there. It is our own responsibility to grab it. Offering unto the Lord. I was reading recently a blog about confession about somebody should do tithes or offering, and I said, I hope people will read and understand their Bibles. We don't want to get into that now, but we know as Christians, you have to put the hand of the Lord are commanded. Some of us are doing tithes, some of us are doing offering, and He says He will be given unto you the way you